Arjun, you might have seen in the event posters that today's theme is that we are having a reverse meeting. And there are very few corporates in India. I am yet to come across any club in this region who have done a reverse meeting ever. So even if you search the internet or the YouTube, you'll probably come across only one or two videos where a club has attempted to do a meeting from the end to the beginning. So which means that if I were to take an analogy of software development, then you are starting with customer appreciation. The customer is very happy, and then you have done the delivery, then you are having the UAT and the acceptance testing, and you are ending the meeting with pre-sales. So it's a very difficult thing to do, to conceptualize and do the thing. Our members have put in a lot of effort, the scripting has happened, and you may find that people may struggle with the English language, especially with respect to tense. So people won't be talking in the present, they'll be talking either in the future or in the past. Because conceptually what is happening is everything you're doing is fictional. An evaluator evaluates without listening to the speech. So evaluator is presenting a fictional account. This kind of a meeting was done in the Toastmasters circle. The last time I know, 6 months back, it was done by a club in Bombay. The Toastmasters club of Mumbai, they had done, and they published that in the Facebook site of our particular district of our country. After that, I think we are probably the first club who is doing that. So let us see how it goes. Normally when we start any meeting, you will have the anchor of the meeting, or what we call in Toastmasters as the parliamentarian. So there will be someone in the meeting who will come and say, please keep your mobile phones on silent mode or completely switched off. But since this is a reverse meeting, the parliamentarian will be doing that at the end of the meeting. So on behalf of the parliamentarian, even before the business part of the meeting starts, I'm requesting all of you to please keep your mobile phones on silent mode, and then we'll start the meeting. So 23rd August 2014, Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. It was the Toastmasters annual convention. A man, he keeps you guessing. He starts with a message. He fluctuates his cadence and his gestures without making them look like distractions. He ties everything together. And his message: anyone has the potential to be great, even if they have long abandoned their greatest aspirations. Ladies and gentlemen, the world champion of public speaking,
Dhananjaya Hetiarachchi. I see something. I see something. Dhananjaya Hetiarachchi. You and I are not very different from this flower, just like this flower is unique. You are unique. All of us have something special that makes us as beautiful. Do you know what makes you special? Now the answer to that can be a little difficult to find, because sometimes life has a cruel way of picking out your petals, breaking you in two, and throwing you into the trash. And when you're broken, it's very difficult to feel special. Mr. Connoisseur, my fellow flies, I can remember the first time I broke. I was 17 years old. I had already flunked high school. and managed to get myself arrested. Now, I wasn't afraid of the cops, but there was one person I was very afraid of, and that was my mom. Raise your hand if you have an emotional mother. Let me see. Put them all together, you get my mom. I can hear her scream outside the police station. Even the cops were afraid. She came up to me, held the iron bars, looked into my eyes, and I saw a tear coming down her face. Now, I've seen my mama cry before, but mothers cry three types of tears. Tears of joy, tears of sorrow, and tears of shame. And when a son sees a mother cry tears of shame, that's a life-changing moment. She looked at me and said, "Son, I want you to be a better man." That night, when I drove home, my dad was waiting for me at home. Now, my dad is a cool dad. Raise your hand if you have a cool dad. Put them all together, you get my dad. My dad came up to me and said, "Son, it's okay. You flunked your exams. You already got arrested. That's fine. You get that from your mother's side. I want you to start working immediately." And I said, "Okay." So my dad took me to meet one of his friends called Sam. Now, Sam was an accountant who had an accounting firm and had generously decided to make me his personal assistant. And there he was. He looked like a teddy bear. But this man was special. I looked at him, and he looked at me. And then he said the most amazing thing. He said, "Son, I see something in you, but I don't know what it is. If you decide to work with me, I can help you find that something." And I was like, "Whoa, that's the first time in my whole life somebody has ever told they see something in me." And I started working for Sam. And every day after work, he used to tell me stories about the world, about history, about culture, about philosophy. And it was much more interesting than what I learned in school. And I discovered I can dream. And I started dreaming, ladies and gentlemen. After 1 year, I went back into high school, completed my exams, and went into college. After successfully completing college, I found a great girl, but not a job. I didn't know what I wanted to do with my life. Have you ever had that problem? And when you're lost, it's difficult to feel special. So I went back to my cool dad. And I said, "Dad, I feel lost." He said, "You are like your mother." So my dad introduced me to this strange club that had a strange name, with strange people talking. On the first meeting, they told me to do something called a table talk. I aced it. But while I was speaking, I see a strange man seated in the back row, humble, simple, the unfailing quality of kindness in his eyes. As soon as I finished, he walked up to me, looked me dead straight in the eye, and said, "Son, I see something in you, but I don't know what it is. If you come here twice a month, maybe we can find that something." And ladies and gentlemen, I discovered I could speak, and I love speaking. And that led me to become a teacher. I know what it's like to not have enough money in your bank. I know what it's like to worry when the bills start coming in. And sometimes, in the middle of the night, I wake up my beautiful wife and I ask her, "Honey, why did you marry me?" She says, I saw something in me. But I still don't know what it is. Ladies and gentlemen, today I'm a dreamer, I'm a speaker, and I learned the unfailing quality of unconditional love from my wife. I was broken, and I've been broken, lost, and broke many times in my life. But the people in my life were able to reach into the trash can and make me whole again. If it was up to me, I would have never been able to do that. And this is why if you have great people in your life, no matter how broke, how lost, or how broken you become, they can piece you back together. Ladies and gentlemen, when I look at you, I see something there. But I don't know.